We got to stay focused on the assignment. Stay yes. focused on what God has called us to do. My house, my church shall be called a house of prayer.
Yes.
If my people who are called by my name should pray. This is what the God has called us to do.
Yes.
Hallelujah. This is what when Nehemiah would be had that, hallelujah, come upon him, that passion came upon him that he wanted to rebuild the wall.
Yes.
Hallelujah. And he decided he's going to rebuild the wall. And he went to the king and he got what he needed. He got, hallelujah, first of all, a letter that he could pass through the forest. And then he got the king to agree, hallelujah, that he can go and build a wall. And the king even sent him to say, go here and take this letter, and they're going to give you some materials to help build a wall. Once Nehemiah get on the assignment and he began to build a wall, who showed up? The devil never showed up, like I told you before, until he realized, hold on, they are actually building this wall.
Apostle,
this wall,
so some people don't know what you're talking about.
Nehemiah.
What was wrong with the wall?
The wall was broken down.
And the gates.
The gates was torn down.
Burned by fire.
Hallelujah. And Nehemiah had to rebuild the wall. He said the anointing came on him. And the passion, he became burdened over the fact that the wall, you know, and I want to touch right there on the burden. Until you become burdened about something, you ain't going to ever really do nothing about it.
You ain't going to ever pray.
And I think too much of our men of God, women of God, Christians, we are burdened over the wrong things. Let's become burdened over the kingdom of God again. Let's become burdened over the doing the things of God again. Let's become burdened over the fact that people ain't praying like they used to pray. Let's become burdened over this fact. How many of you saw the house in its former glory? How do you see it now? Is the house, my God, worthy to be called the house of God? Can we compare to the former glory? Is there any power being demonstrated in your churches, in our churches? Are people being healed? Are people being saved? Are people being delivered? Are people being discipled? Are people being set free by the power of God? Hallelujah. And if that's not happening, then we got to become burdened and begin to pray. Hey, Lord, we need a revival. We need a revival. Remember, revival is not for sinners. Revival is for Christians. Hallelujah. We need to be revived. We need to be set on fire. We need to get back on the right track. We have drifted so far from the landmark. And he's saying now we need to get back on the right track. Hallelujah. We need to get back doing what God has called his people
to do.
Hallelujah.
Oh my God.
And that is to pray. And once Nehemiah got that passion and that burden, he gone and he said, I'm going to build this wall. Hallelujah. And he said, if I got to find men in the city and try train them how to build a wall, we going to build a wall. And that's what he did. He got some men. And once he started, help began to come.
Hey.
People began to come. Different tribes began to come.
People began to sow.
Hallelujah. And people began to sow. And they began to build a wall. All the while, they had no resistance building the wall. But as soon as the work began, the wall began to go up. Then all of a sudden, Sanballat, who else? Tobiah, who else?
Goshen.
Now they are showing up and they are trying to say, who are these feeble Jews? Do they think they could build this wall up again? And when they look and saw the wall was going, then they began to try now. These same Sanballat and Tobias and Goshen began to come up with their strategy of how they're going to stop this wall from being built. Hallelujah. And they began to do all sorts of things. But Nehemiah said, I'm on the wall. I'm not moving. Nehemiah said, I need me. Hallelujah. I need some warriors who could stand with the sword in their hand. Some of you going to have to be up on the wall with your spear in your hand. You're going to have to be putting mortar on with one hand, holding your spear with the other hand. And that's what they began to do. And so when they realized they couldn't come there, they set another trap. They say, meet us in the valley of Ono. Hallelujah.
It was a trap.
It was a trap for him to leave off the wall and go over to Ono. But Nehemiah, being a man of prayer, said, Oh no. I am doing a good work.
Hallelujah.
I am up on the wall.
Yes.
I can't come down.
Yes.
My assignment is not finished yet.
Yes.
So I got to stay on the wall.
Yes.
And I got to do what God called me to do,
Hallelujah.
Which is to make sure that my city is secured against any attack of the devil.
Hey!
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
And so we got to stay on the wall. We can't be ignorant of his devices.
Oh my God.
They set all sort of traps.
That's right.
Trying to get Nehemiah to pull him out of his position.
My God, but I never saw oh no.
That's what it
says. They said meet us over in
right
oh
there.
No.
Verse 2 of which chapter that is?
Chapter 6.
He said,
oh my God.
Meet us over. Hallelujah.
Meet us over.
Over in the plain, sorry.
Plains.
The plain of oh
of
no.
no.
Of
hallelujah.
Oh no.
Hallelujah. But
look
they,
at that.
What did they do? They thought to do him mischief. It was a trap. They were setting a trap for him.
So whenever you're doing the work of God,
yes,
the enemy is angry.
Yes,
the enemy is outraged. The wall was broken down long, you know.
Yeah, nobody
the
was saying
was
that.
The gates was burning up long time.
Nobody was doing that.
But as soon as Nehemiah, the Bible says his name means Yahweh who comforts.
Yes,
got a burden.
Yes,
now he had a job. He used to work in the palace.
Yes,
but the Bible said one day he came before the king, and the king said, "I've never seen you look like this." What's going on?
Something.
And Nehemiah was like, I can't bother
his
you with
this. His soul was vexed.
So his soul was vexed and
yes,
broken.
Yes.
And the king said, you was my cupbearer.
Yes.
Nehemiah was a cupbearer in the palace.
The palace.
Come on.
But before he became a cupbearer, he knew that he was a Jew.
Yes.
Yes. That's
hallelujah.
Right.
Hallelujah.
See, this is where we got to remember.
Come on.
That before we become something out there,
before.
We got to remember the kingdom.
Before you became a Baptist, before you became a Church of God, before you became a Catholic, you are a Christian. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
And so you got to remember, we all serve in the same God. So it shouldn't be this big fight, everybody trying to pull everyone down. Hey, if the kingdom of darkness is rising up, hallelujah, against churches, then that means all the churches, whether you're Catholic, Anglican, Baptist, hallelujah, if you serve in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, if he's your God, we should be coming together. Hallelujah, and fight in the kingdom of darkness.
Oh my God, Apostle.
Hallelujah.
Oh my God. Somebody out there say, oh my God.
Oh my God.
Oh my God. This is powerful, Apostle. Y'all know we've been waiting for Apostle to open this scripture up for like 2 weeks.
Amen.
We've been waiting for 2 weeks there,
yeah,
but
yeah.
Oh no.
Oh
my God, this is powerful. And Apostle,
we can't
so
go.
The enemy is trying to get us,
yeah.
to get you.
Uh-huh.
To get everybody
yes.
who has been called with a divine assignment,
yes.
even just as a Christian,
yes.
he's just trying to get you
uh-huh.
from the things of God
uh-huh.
to a valley call.
Oh no. Trying to pull you away. But you got to tell him, oh no.
Hallelujah.
Oh no.
Oh no.
I'm doing a good work. I can't come down.
Come on.
Hallelujah.
So Nehemiah
and that's why
was fighting.
He uses people just like he used
yes.
Sanballat, Tobiah, hallelujah, and Gushan.
They were wicked demons.
They were wicked people. He used people to get the people of God discouraged. Hallelujah. They get you discouraged. Hallelujah. And I got to tell you, people of God, it's time for us to be strong. Hallelujah. We got to be strong. Do not be ignorant of Satan's devices. What do you mean? Hallelujah. You think the devil ain't a lie? Come on, he's the father of lies. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
My God, he will lie. He will tell a lie to get you out of the church. Hallelujah.
Yes.
He will get somebody to get up and say some things about you to get you out of the church. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And so you got to realize the plot of the enemy. Why all of a sudden it just started happening now when the wall was going up?
Because the enemy wanted to stop the wall.
It's a plan of the devil.
Yes. So,
it's a device of the devil.
So, Apostle, I love what the scripture says, that now Nehemiah was given a leave of absence.
Yes.
From the king.
Yes.
To go back to Jerusalem.
Yes.
And build the wall and hang the gates. Now, watch this. This thing takes like over 52 weeks to do.
Come on.
If you read the book of Nehemiah, over 52 weeks.
Yes.
But here's what I wanted to show you people tonight. Praise God. I mean, Nehemiah, when he made that decision, he had no helpers.
Nope.
He had no money.
Nope.
He didn't even know how to build no wall. He
Come
was
on.
A cupbearer.
Cupbearer.
But because he had a passion.
Yes.
And a burden, praise God.
Yes.
The Bible said he went in prayer.
Yes.
And ask God and petition God.
Yes.
And say, God, that is the wall of Jerusalem.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Listen to me. When the walls are broken down,
yes.
it means that, praise God, you have no protection.
Come on.
Oh, Jesus.
And that's
Come
what
on.
Happened.
You have no protection.
Come on.
Praise God. When the gates are burned with fire, Ooh. You have no resistance.
No resistance.
People can walk in
and walk out.
They can keep all your stuff.
All to your property.
Because why? All up and down in your house.
Yeah.
Whenever your wall is broken down,
yeah,
it means that there is no boundary. There is no limit.
No.
The enemy can come in and out of your house,
uh-huh,
and do whatever they please. But I thank God tonight. Oh no. The devil is alive.
Oh no. Oh no.
We
can't come down. And so people say, well, what wall? Look in the spirit. That's what we're talking about. There's a spiritual wall. Amen. Hallelujah. We're talking about tonight. It's a spiritual wall. Prayer builds the spiritual wall back up. Hallelujah. Okay, let me give you a good example that can help you understand. You know, some of you that need a little more understanding. Let's remember, and we're going to use a movie to just get it. The movie, they call it Star Trek, right? Hallelujah. And you know, they were supposed to be in space. This is where the movie is. Hallelujah. The final frontier. Hallelujah. Captain Spock and whoever else and all of them in space. Now, every time when this ship was going to go into a battle, you will hear the captain say, put up the shields. Put up the four shields. But you never saw the shield.
No.
You never saw that shield.
No.
Amen. But they all you would hear that little Klingon looking guy, whatever he was, hallelujah, would say, the shields are up. What do you name?
Worf.
Yeah, that's Kim Beeble. Worf. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. What? All you would say, shields are up.
Yes.
And then all of a sudden you see the next ship firing at them. And you would feel the ship will shake, but yes, they wasn't getting hit.
Come on,
right.
And every time when they fired that ship at the Enterprise, every time they fired the Enterprise, the ship will get hit. But the ship will shake, but no one get hit. But you will hear that same little fella say, Captain, shield at the front is at 40% now,
yes,
after that last blast.
Yes.
So every time the devil fires at us, the shield is being weakened. Hallelujah. And so what they have to do, the armor is getting weakened. That's why we got to continue in prayer.
Yes.
So every time the armor gets weak, we build it back up. We strengthen the armor. So when Satan fires again, hallelujah, we back at 100% and be able to take a hit.
Yeah.
If they fire too fast and they don't get the shield repaired quick enough, then all of a sudden now, those things will begin to come true and hit the ship. And
Jesus.
This is what we cannot allow to happen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. That's why it's important for the church to rise up in prayer, for us to stay on the wall, for us to know who the enemy is and who the devil is and know who we are fighting and continue to pray and bind and cancel the plans of the enemy.
Oh my God, Apostle, somebody give God a praise if you're still with us tonight.